And welcome back. In the next few tutorials, I'm going to show you how to make sure that your viewers understand what you're trying to get across. Often when you're creating a screencast, there are a lot of things going on the screen, and you don't want those watching to get distracted by something that's irrelevant. The first thing I'm going to cover, and what's in this tutorial, are zooms and pans. A zoom is changing the scale of your video, which gives the effect to the viewer of getting closer or farther away. While pan is moving the video to focus on something else, kind of like changing where your camera is pointing. Most of the time in screencasts, zooms and pans are used together. Now before I get into the how to add zooms and pans in Camtasia, let me quickly cover when to add them. As a general rule, zoom in when you need to show detail and when you want your viewers to focus in on something. Zoom out to show context, the whole application or recording, or how what you just showed relates to the rest of the screen. This is important to keep your viewers from getting lost. Oftentimes throughout your video, you'll zoom in and out regularly. Of course, you don't want to zoom or pan too often or you'll make your viewers sick, but that's the general principle. When to add pans is pretty straightforward. Use them to make sure your area of focus is showing, and in the center if that makes sense. While there are several ways to add zooms and pans to your video in Camtasia, I'm going to begin with SmartFocus, because it gives you a good start that you can learn from and still easily adjust. What SmartFocus does is, while you're recording, it keeps track of where your mouse, windows, and possibly other significant parts of your screen are. Then during editing, it makes the best guess at where to zoom and pan at various points in your video. It only works with recordings made with Camtasia, and when you set your canvas size smaller than the area you recorded. Alright, enough generalities, let's look into some real life examples in this project. To add SmartFocus, first select all of your screen recording clips. If they're still on the same track, just right click the track head, which is to the left, and choose Select All on Track. Then go up to the Animations tab, drag the SmartFocus animation down to the selected clips, and let go. Okay, there we go. Notice all of these triangles? They are animations. How many you personally have on your project will depend on a lot of things, so don't worry if you only have a few or a ton. The triangles are actually arrows, and if we zoom into the timeline using this slider, so that they're not all squished up, we'll begin to see where the animations begin and where they end. Now remember that SmartFocus gives you a good place to start, but we'll definitely want to check and tweak where needed. So let's start at the beginning of this video. That's way to the left. Click here to jump there instantly. Now we'll just scrub along to verify that the zooms and pans SmartFocus gave us are in order. Notice at this point the animation doesn't do very much, so let's just delete it. Too much movement, especially unnecessary movement, can be distracting to our viewers. I'm going to keep working my way down the timeline, making sure everything looks good, and fixing anything that's not zoomed or panned the way I want. I'll stop when I come to something interesting. At this point in the video, I want the viewers to look here. So as I mentioned earlier, we should zoom in to show details and focus. There's no animation right here, but we can just grab this one since it's doing what we want, just not at the right point, and reposition it on the timeline. Great. You may notice that sometimes SmartFocus gets the zoom right, but may get the timing off a bit. The fix though, as you saw, is easy. Right before this point in the video, I've shown some details of the interface, so I was zoomed in. But here, I want to go back to talking about the application generally. So it's probably a great place to zoom out and show the entire screen to give the viewers a sense of where they were and what else is going on. This will help them better remember and recognize what we've just shown when they see it for themselves on their own. Notice right here in the video, where I'm talking about this area of the screen, there's a zoom, but centering it would look a bit nicer. So let's move the playhead after the animation, then drag the video on the canvas where we want. Since we're panned to the edge of the video, make sure to use the yellow alignment lines to verify you're on the right border. Don't forget to preview the section of the video you just changed to make sure it looks how you want. Here, SmartFocus zoomed in, but it doesn't look crystal clear. Perhaps that's picky, but we want our screencasts to look nice. So pay attention to this next tip. It's probably the most important thing you can do to make your videos crisp. After moving the playhead after the animation, right or control click on the video in the canvas and choose scale to actual pixels. This will scale it to 100%, exactly what was on your screen when you recorded it. There, that looks better. Zooming all of the way back out is easy. Just move the playhead after the animation, right click on the video in the canvas, and choose scale to fit. If you find that any animations are too fast or too slow, just drag an end to stretch it longer, which will slow down the animation, or shorter, which will speed it up. If you ever get to a place where SmartFocus didn't add an animation, but you need one, or if you don't want to use SmartFocus at all, manually adding zooms and other animations is easy. For example, to zoom in, just go to the Animations tab and choose Zoom In. Then drag it down to your clip on the timeline. This will scale your video to 100%, making it perfectly clear. You'll also probably want to adjust what's shown in the canvas. Use Zoom In anytime you need to show details or make text very legible. To zoom back out, use the Zoom Out animation, which will scale your video to fit completely within the bounds of the canvas. This is great for helping viewers understand how the details you just showed fit into the whole picture. As with any animation, you can tweak it on the canvas, timeline, and properties. Whew. This has been a long tutorial, but I hope you see the power of not just zooms and pans to make your message clearer to your viewers, but also of animations to do most anything to your media. Okay, go add some zooms and pans to your video with SmartFocus or the other animations. Save it, then go take a break. You've earned it. But after that, come back for the next tutorial where I'll talk about using annotations to increase clarity even more.